And here we are with our finished project. And as you see, that will be a very nice addition to our home and will make moving this plant around very easy. Hello friends, welcome to the Sunday Show. Today we're going to show you how to turn three pieces of lattice into this very nice plant trivet. So stick around and we're going to show you how we did this. So use the previous piece that you cut to mark the next piece. And right now we have three pieces cut. We're going to need a total of 10 pieces. At least that's our initial calculation. Again, bring your piece to the blade so you can see where you're going to cut it. The advantage of the bandsaw is that the blade has a very, very thin curve, so you don't have to worry about cutting inside or outside the line. We have to repeat that.
Do you know my axis here?
Yeah. Until we have 20 pieces. These are lattice pieces. They're fairly inexpensive in most every big box store. I didn't do a very good cut before, so try to do a close-up. Hopefully I'll do a better cut. I don't know what happened before. But so here is our dry fitting. We've cut all our pieces, as you see, and we have created a layer that is the bottom, and then a layer that is the top. We are going to put a few more in the top, and we're going to eyeball the distance because, again, these are not going to be visible in any way. However, we are going to add both strength and also thickness by putting one more layer in the bottom. So I will leave those here. I'm going to take all the top off. The important thing here is that your corners are square, and I'm going to use a square to ensure that is the case here. Before we tack them. Again, this is our dry fitting. Like them like that. Oh, probably I need to be a little more than that, right? Mm-hmm. Okay, during the actual fitting, we'll make sure that everything is flush. All right, let's do the fitting and we'll be right back. So choose one of the corners to start. Make sure that it is very flat. Use your square and make sure it is perfectly aligned. Put a dab of glue. That's a technical term, dab. That's a big dab. Make sure you align it again. How did I have it before? No, I didn't have it like that. Is it doing anything? I don't think so. I don't think it's shooting. It's not going to go through, honey. Let's do the four squares, the four corners first. I don't think it's shooting anything. Shooting blanks. Can you stop the camera?
You're on.
All right, repeat that for all the corners. We're not going to show you everyone. Ensure again that your corner is square. Do we have any time here that they have small heads? I think these are two big heads and they don't go through.
It's a shame.
What's the same?
That the big heads don't want to go through.
If that will go. I don't know if did it shoot or
looks like it.
Well, actually, the Hitachi ones don't look any different than the standard ones.
They are not supposed to look different. No, they didn't. Only one it looks like. Two? Is it recording?
Mm-hmm.
All right, keep in mind that this is actually the bottom.
Lantern.
Well, we can put the glue in. Needs to come more out. Mm-hmm. All right, and the last piece. It's okay. That's the bottom. It's not visible. We should have put glue. You want it there? Yes?
Slightly over. Slightly huh? over.
Okay, move it.
I can't move it while I'm holding the camera.
Only one in this. Tell me when you're ready.
Go.
Okay. Let's align them and then we need to knock them on because the adhesive can... Well, can you stop recording when you hammer them? Give me one of the small pieces, please. Okay, stop. I guess I was trying to put them in on those. And what we're doing with the clamp is closing the gap. All right, let's turn it around. And this is in essence our support structure for the whole thing. No, you have a preference of what's top and what's bottom. All right. You know, that's how it goes on the video. Alright. I will put glue in here. Put them up. You can move it a little bit if you're not happy with placement. And when you're happy, tell me and I will take it. Are you happy?
Glue.
We have to tack it before the glue starts.
Why? Because I want to be able to move them after they're all on
there. Well, you're not going to be able to move them in a few moments either.
Thus the scratchy door.
Right, and the whining.
So the reason for the staple is because our... Raj is a little longer than the thickness of the two boards. So we use the staple to use the old staples to kind of get a grip and get a hold of this.
We use the clamp to clamp
what
them
did I
together.
Say?
You said you use the staple to get the staple.
Ah.
So we use the clamp.
Yeah. What she said.
So we use the clamp to grab those two boards to, because the staple went through the two boards.
Ready?
We use the clamp to get through and make the third board secure.
So you're wiggling them as you move, as you get on there, you're wiggling them there.
And are we out again? Yep. Are we here? All right, tell me what you want to start. So do you this to be on a carpet, so you want big wheels or you want little wheels?
Smaller wheels if you have them.
I made a little bigger, deeper than that.
Why?
Because the screw is a little longer. What are you doing?
This.
Excuse
is not the right.
Yes, it is. Squeeze it in.
It is not the right one. It doesn't go in.
It does go in. It just has to be. Here, good.
There.
Stay here, please. Can you bring yours, please? Stop, please. Please if I can wait. We have four more to finish,
mm-hmm.
of the same size.
We have a whole ton of them. We have plenty.
And the ones that went perfect, we weren't filming.
Life doesn't go perfect.
Life isn't, but filming should.
Nope.
One more, please. Thank you. Pilot holes are essential on this because you will split the wood otherwise. And it's a good practice to make the first one. So your screw will not, your piece will not move as you are screwing it on. And then you can make the other three. You want to use the other light?
The thing.
It looks dark when I look
there. There's plenty of light on the camera.
That would be fun though, right?
Sure.
It will help you if it was in the hole.
Yes.
Put it in the hole.
Sorry. I tried to let the camera record, but I need to have my hand there too. For small projects like this, these little screwdrivers are invaluable. And the last one. This, as you see, is our finished product. Now, we initially thought of using this kind of caster, but for this specific size, that ended up being too big. And of course, there are smaller casters. You have to decide what caster you're going to use based on your needs and the weight you plan to put on this. But as you can see, this moves very nicely, if I don't drop it off the table. And it is a very nice and simple plant trivet. Is that what you call it? Okay. And here we are with our finished project, and as you see, that will be a very nice addition to our home and will make moving this plant around very easy. You can see the detail of our trivet, and we reinforce the sides, and it is a very simple, easy, and very inexpensive project to complete. No, Max. Is that centered? No. Tell me. Is that good there?
Yeah.
So we'll make another one for this? And here's our trivet that allows us to move our potting plant with ease around. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, and if you did, please smash the like button. If you didn't, the other button works as well. Share and comment our video so we can continue to generate content for you. We appreciate all your support. We are halfway through our next goal to 400 subscribers. We're at 355 as of today. So I appreciate you subscribing and watching our videos. Keep doing that. Again, in 45 more videos, we're going to do another giveaway. So continue liking, subscribing, and following the channel so that you will be considered to be in the drawing. Again, I will see you Wednesday with tips and tricks, and next Sunday with another build. I hope you enjoy this week's simple build.